Hello guys, this is my Alfa Romeo 155 from 1994, and today we are finalizing the subject of the horns not working. The theory behind my videos here is not just to teach you how to diagnose a horn, but really to how to diagnose a simple electrical system with a relay.
So guys, this is the relay box inside the car. This is the relay for the horn. Just to remind you what I was talking about in the other videos. When I play the horn, nothing happens. Just the relay is... It's working just the coil. I take out the relay and I play the horn just to guarantee that the problem was that relay on that spot. Next thing I want to do is to grab my wire, and this wire will go, so just a moment, this wire will go on the pins that have the present battery in the exit, for this case the horn, and I will connect it to. And behold, the horn is working. In this way, I know for sure the problem was always on the relay. It's funny these things, how these things happen, because I did an initial diagnosis that the relay was good, and I was wrong. That's why we have always to do some other diagnosis to make sure that our own diagnosis is right or wrong. Now, on this case of the Alfa 155, this is very easy to see, because we have a lot of equal relays and we can switch them around like this. They are very easy to reach, and as you can see, the problem was always the relay. Why didn't I do this on the beginning? I don't know. So, but let's just talk about this for a little longer. So you to understand the importance of knowing how a relay works. Guys, so here we have the relay. This relay is very simple to understand. Like I said in the previous videos, these two pins are to electrify the coil. The coil accepts this electricity and then pulls this tab and connects these two pins. On this particular relay, it actually connects this one with these two. These two here are twins, but there are relays, this is very common on Fiat products, but there are relays that when the relay is not excited, the connection is done between this and this one, or this one, and when it is excited, it switches from this one to this one, or vice versa. But let's imagine this. When it's off, when the relay is off, it has continuity between this one and this one. And when it's on, it has continuity between this one and this one. But this particular relay does not do that. You have to see the numbers. These two here are 87. When it's different, it can have 87A. On there or there. This one is this one, these two pins are twins. Let's call it that. So we excite the 85 and 86, and then we connect the 30 with the two 87s. So we have the tab for the 87, okay? When it closes with this tab here, it goes around, and goes to this one. Okay, my wire is doing this path. Okay, why I am so keen to show you how this relay works. I have a lot of relays on my car to switch, right? Right, but, and you are totally correct. But remember, in the newer cars, the relays are very difficult to find, because they are very hidden. A lot of the relays are integrated on the ECUs, on the various components. They are not reachable. I can give you a case of the Peugeot 207 and the 407, for example. Because of some relays that are bad, you have to switch all of the engine box, not the control unit, but the electrical box. That box is really expensive because of some shitty relays that go bad. Like the steering column on the Fiat, for example, the Puntos and some other models. They are just welded relays that go bad. How can now let's imagine this. You have a modern car, more modern car, or this car here, and you are left stranded because the relay that that went wrong, that went bad, is your ignition relay, for example, or it is your fuel pump relay, your light relay for the low beam or the high beam or the whatever. And you cannot switch around the fuses because you lose another function that you need to drive your car. The importance that I find of knowing how the relay works is very, for me, it's very important. Because if you can, do you remember these two pins here? If you check out my video about the window switches, you will recognize these two tabs, these two pins. When they press together, they have to make perfect contact. Perfect, just perfect. Because there is a lot of amps passing through these two points. And if you just... I have a lot of relays at home. But I like to test my work. Like you saw, I was wrong about this relay because they are really very temperamental, like you may know. But I want to fix this relay. I will fix this relay. I am pressing on this tab. I am trying, because this screwdriver is very, it's like a sandpaper thing. It's not smooth. And I can take out, I try to take out that blackness of the charcoal. When it's totally smooth, I will put some Vaseline here. I don't have a better product right now. And I will work with this relay on the horn. I want to see how many days, months, years, hours it will hold up. Because I want to make sure that my work, my professional work, and my home work, it's good enough. I don't want to make videos so you think, oh, this guy is the best. And then, oh, he's wrong. No, I want to test myself. Another thing, I want to see if this will hold up. I want to see how much time this coil will work, will last. This relay has more than 25 years. And I want to know how much longer can it hold. Okay. Now, I will do just one more quick test, not on the relay. Enough of relays for today. Just put some grease on there. And I will test the horns itself. Some of you are really beginning on this stuff. And I want you to understand how can you test a horn. Imagine you are buying used horns. I do this all the time because the horns of my cars are all equal, are all the same, more or less. And I test my horns. Should it be horns or horns? I don't know. Not horns, horns. I test it on spot. I connect it to the battery of my car and I test the pieces, the parts on spot. This one doesn't work, etc., etc. This one is good, this one is good. Okay, let's do it. So the thing is, you are on a scrapyard, you are buying the new old stock stuff horns. You connect to, you leave the house with two wires, just two simple wires, man. Okay, the testing wires that I've talked you about in other videos. Connect, if you have to see if you have plus and minus on the horns. Most of the times it does not have. Don't worry, you can test it both ways. A lot of times it will work both ways. Okay, connected. And now press firmly on the contacts of the battery. You will not get shock. Look, you can touch the battery as much as you want. You will not get shock. Not like the movies, okay? One is working. Okay, you can buy this one. And the other one should be another tone. I think higher. Okay? Connect firmly. It doesn't matter which one first. Okay, it was higher. These two combined will make... Sorry. We'll make the sound that you are familiar with, like the sound of my Alpha 155. In fact, all of my four cars have the same high-low horns. So, I am constantly buying new horns for my cars. So, here we have it. I put some Vaseline. I know that there are better things. The dielectric grease is... just for this kind of stuff. I don't have it. I cannot reach that products here on where I am. But you have to have in mind that the use of that greases is to avoid the electrical arc that I talked to you about in the last video, on the videos of the window switch. This grease, it will also prevent electrical arc. So I clean the contacts, I put some grease, and now we are testing the relay.